My name is Philip Harrelson, and I would like to welcome you back to the Barnabas study. And in this video, I'm going to see if I can kill not two birds with one stone, but I'm going to see if I can kill three birds with one stone. A few weeks ago, I put up some videos about Thomas Watson, who was one of the Puritans that I have found very helpful throughout my life and ministry. And I was actually turned on to the Puritans probably 30 years ago now by Brother E.L. Jolly. And Brother Jolly was the he put together the bibliographies for the Word of Flame Press in St. Louis. And I know that books have changed so much now. A lot of them are electronic. But Brother Jolly was very, very adept at knowing books and authors. And he blessed a lot of preachers over the course of his ministry by being able to recommend books that were helpful to him. And so he's the one that kind of turned me on to Thomas Watson. And I did mention that one of my favorite book of Watson's is a little volume called The Mischief of Sin. And there are five sermons that is in that little book. I think it's like less than 100 pages, but it is a very, very good book that I have benefited from over the course of the years. And so I want to finish up with the volumes that I have in my library that Thomas Watson has written. And here is a book that is, again, published. This is published by Banner of Truth. Banner of Truth is a company that's not only in the United States, but also in the United Kingdom. And they have done a very, very good job of reprinting a lot of the Puritans over the years. In fact, a lot of the volumes that you see behind me, and also some of the ones that you can't see, those are published by Banner of Truth. And there's something about the quality of their hardbound books is just incredible. That when you hold them in your hands, they're just a very, very positive and good, it's just a well-made product. Dust jackets, the inner binding, most of them are Smythe sawn. And they work very well for a diligent student of the Word. But the first one I want to tell you about is the one called the Ten Commandments. And what he does in here, obviously, Watson is going to go through the Ten Commandments. And then here is what he does after he gets through the Ten Commandments. About the first 175 pages of the book pretty well deals with that. And then he gets into an area where he calls the law and sin, and about how that law helps us to be able to understand our sin. And then the last part of that book is where he talks about the way of salvation, faith, repentance, the Word, baptism, the Lord's Supper, prayer, just some various things where that he goes through in working through that. Another volume that I have, and this again is a very, very helpful book, and it is called The Art of Divine Contentment. This is probably one of Watson's most popular works, and it is not only is it there are practical illustrations, but there's just a lot of devotional material that you can find in here. Here's one of the quotes from the book: "Discontent is to the soul as a disease is to the body. It puts out of temper and greatly hinder puts it out of temper and greatly hinders its regular and sublime motions heavenward. For my part, I know of no ornament in religion that more bespangles a man than this of contentment." And what he's doing is he is talking about, and you are as well, you know this as well as I do, that one of the things about especially Western culture is the fact that we are very discontent because our capitalistic society moves us into a place to always think that your phone is not good enough, your car is not good enough, your computer is not good enough. The clothes you wear, they're good for 2 months, and then you got to get something else to replace that. And what he does is he works through Philippians 4 and 11, I have learned in whatsoever state I am therewith to be content. And I mentioned this in the other videos, that what they would do is they would present what they called a doctrine, and then later on, after they worked through that doctrine, they would add what they call the applications. His doctrine is this: it is not enough for Christians to hear their duty, but they must also learn their duty. And then he begins to say, okay, what keeps us from learning? Well, sliding what we hear. He said that the Lord is the pearl of great price. And if we look at that and we do not value the work and the kingdom of God, then we're going to slight that. And then he talks about how we forget what we hear. James chapter 1, you know about that, that the hearer of the word and the doer of the word, the one that's only a hearer, he hears what the word says, but he looks like a man that looks into a mirror and sees his imperfections and sees what he needs to take care of. And then if he's just a hearer, he walks away from that and he never makes any real changes in his life. And so he talks about that. The second thing I have learned, the second doctrine, is good things are hard to come by. And he says that we must study and exercise ourselves because spiritual things are against our nature. Now, how true is that? I would just say that that's very much the case, that there's times where that we really have to work toward contentment. Here's what he says. He says, discontent is unworthy of the relation in which we stand to God. A Christian that is invested with the title and privilege of sonship, he is an heir of promise. Consider the free grace that has fallen upon you. And then he uses this text in 2 Samuel chapter 13 and verse 4. Why art thou, being the king's son, lean from day to day? Why are you discontented? How unworthy it is for us to be discontented. And again, I have to say that is probably one of the chief sins. And we don't like to look at it like that. We like to profess, there's no sin, but discontentment in itself is something that if we are not careful, it can wreck our lives. Now, the third bird or the third book is what is called the Puritan Pulpit. And this is the Puritan Pulpit of Thomas Watson. And there are 10 sermons that are found in this book. A Christian on Earth Still in Heaven, The Beauty of Grace, The Preciousness of a Soul, The Saint's Spiritual Delight, The Trees of Righteousness Blossoming and Bringing Forth Fruit, and then The Spiritual Watch. And so all of these are just sermons that Thomas Watson preached back in his day. And again, all three of these volumes have been very helpful to me in my ministry over the years, and I would commend these volumes to you as well. So again, thank you for stopping by, and I appreciate you watching the video, and we'll see you again in the next one. The Lord bless you.